Nesting in Premiere Pro lets you combine several clips into a single nested sequence, allowing you to treat multiple clips like one. If you're familiar with After Effects, it's essentially the same as a precom. And nesting is really useful in quite a few ways, so today we're going to look at a handful of those things that it does usefully. Off we go. Why are you still here? Please cut. Release me. One of the ways that I use nesting the most is with things like my hosting sections from Film Riot, or for these episodes for that matter. We'll cut down the raw hosting performance and then nest all the clips together into one sequence, then bring all the cuts back using scene edit detection. This might sound like useless and ridiculous, but it allows us to get right into cutting the episode while still having full and easy control over sound and color for all the hosting sections. So when my timeline eventually looks like this with all the hosting sections spread out, I can come into my nested sequence, drop on any grade using an adjustment layer, and place in my processed audio. And when I go back, it's all updated perfectly. So now, when changes are needed, I won't have to re-export or do any footage replacement. It just keeps all my options open so I can make changes fast. Another useful usage I utilize is with music. Take this artlist panel, for instance. When you see these three lines here, that means the stems for that song are available. So I can download all the layers of the song, place them in their own sequence, stack them, then alter the mix or take elements out where needed to dial this in perfectly to what I want. Then I could drag this in as a nested bit of audio, where I can, again, pop back into that sequence whenever I want to make changes to those stems. While we don't necessarily do this often, nesting can be useful for object removals. Continuing to use the stand-ups as an example, imagine you shoot all your footage, but then in the edit realize the mic was in shot. I'm not saying that happened recently, but it happened recently. One option is to mask each clip individually, which means if you need to scale the footage later, you have to adjust both the original clip and the separately masked area covering the mic. Instead, you can nest the stand-up clips as we did before, open the nest, grab a still from here, then in Photoshop, we'll quickly remove that mic, bring the new clean image back in, place it over our string of footage, and mask just that area. Now when we come back to our main comp, every clip is corrected, and you can scale or adjust the entire stand-up footage as a single clip without worrying about multiple layers. One of my favorite series that we've been doing on my Film Riot channel is Amazing Effects. And in that series, we break down classic movie effects and take a peek behind the scenes at what made those moments work, which we can't show here because copyright. But in that show, we're constantly working with multiple images, especially PNGs of different sizes, and it's common to run into inconsistencies. For example, if you're trying to show two posters side by side and apply a digital zoom, you might notice that one zooms faster than the other due to their different resolutions. Even effects like drop shadows can look uneven since the scale of each image affects how the shadow is rendered. To fix this, first position the poster the way that you want them in frame, then nest them together. Now any zoom or effect you apply to the nest will treat the posters as a single unit, keeping scale and effects consistent, which will give you a much cleaner end result. You can also do this to basic effects like a clone shot. It's easier to work with a digital zoom or a shake if the two cropped clips are inside that nested sequence. The same logic will apply to logos or watermarks. If you're consistently using graphics like a studio logo throughout a certain clip, nesting can save you time and make future adjustments a lot easier. For example, let's say you're creating a behind-the-scenes video and want a studio credit to appear whenever the original footage is shown. Start by nesting the full clip, then add the logo or credit inside that nest. Now, instead of pulling straight from the file, you can pull from the nested sequence so that the credit is now always there without having to add it manually over and over. If you're using effects like warp stabilizer or speed ramps on a clip that doesn't match your sequence settings, you might run into issues. To fix that, just nest the clip. Then make sure the nested sequence matches the clip's original resolution and frame rate, which lets the effect process correctly. And once you're done, you can drop that nest back into your main timeline like any other clip. So there's a handful of ways to use this feature, and at points, it may seem like a bit more work up front, but once you're at the end of an edit trying to beat the clock, being able to jump in and make quick adjustments is incredibly useful. But that's it for today. As always, if there's something that you would like to see us cover in the future, let us know in the comments below. And don't forget to like and subscribe, or I don't know, but could you still?